What's up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of My Hip Hop Review. This is your boy Reg here, and the album I'm about to review today is Just Ice's second studio album, Kool and Deadly, released in 1987 on Fresh Records. You guys should know who, in case you guys don't know who Just Ice is, he is one of the, he is an MC from, like, Bronx, New York. He's one of, like, the originators of bringing gangster rap into the masses and shit like that. And also with bringing reggae and hip-hop, you know, combining that together more and shit like that. Working with KRS-One and shit like that. Working with Mentronics. Definitely one of the most slept on MCs, period, and shit. If you ask me. Because you don't hear, like, a lot of people mention him and shit like that. Give me 1 second. Alright. Let me turn this down a little bit. So yeah, Just Ice, you know, he's an MC from the Bronx, New York. From what I looked up, he was originally a bouncer at clubs and shit like that. And so he was like one of the cats that really brought like gangster rap into the masses and shit like that. Well, not into like the masses, but into like New York and shit, you know. And so with that being said, he had signed into the independent label Sleeping Bag and shit like that. Fresh Sleeping Bag to be exact, you know, the same label that EPMD's first two albums, Strictly Business and Unfinished Business, were both classic albums, by the way. And so he had dropped Back to the Old School in 1986, which was all produced by Mantronics and shit like that. Very dope album and shit. I know that's like an early hip hop classic, if you ask me. At the same time, I think like 1 year later, he got picked by the police and shit like that because he was booked for like murdering like a drug dealer or some shit. And so that kind of like raised his profile and shit like that. And so he actually, from what I looked up and shit like that, he actually, you know, was proven innocent. He actually got away more. He was proven innocent and shit like that. So. And around that time, too, in 87, he basically got no more notoriety by, you know, throwing shots at Run DMC and shit like that, from what I looked up, too. So, yeah, he was like, you know, he was getting that reputation for that raw, that in-your-face kind of rapper and shit like that. And so, that same year, he had, you know, kind of broken ties with Mantronics. I couldn't exactly find the reason why they broke up and shit. I'm guessing it was on, you know, good terms. He wanted to try a different sound. And so enter KRS-One. You know, KRS-One had just dropped the Criminal Minded album with Boogie Down Productions and shit like that. And so he had hooked up with Just Ice, you know, and that kind of started off, you know, their partnership, friendship, to say the least. And so, and the thing about this album, too, is that, you know, this was kind of like some of the first times, like, you got to hear, you know, KRS-One produce solo and shit like that, you know what I'm saying, and stuff like that. So he kind of produced, like, a lot of beats solo. He produced this album, and then he produced this album, which I'm going to review sometime either today or tomorrow and shit. So with this album, is released in 1987, and it also is called Justicizms and shit, if you can see it right there. By the way, huge shout out to my homeboy Mike Sears off Speaker Club Podcast for giving me this album for free and shit like that, because he said he didn't particularly care for this album, so I was like, you know what, just give it to me. I don't give a fuck, you know. So yeah, dope album cover. Kind of, you know, as you can see, he has a fucking grills on his fucking mouth and shit. You know, got the fucking Jenga hat right there and shit. Which I need to get my hands on this hat, though. I don't give a fuck what no one says. Got like a classic picture of Just Isaac. Like, you probably seen and shit like that. Yeah. Alright. So with that being said, this album has 8 original songs, but one of the songs is like a 12-inch single edit and shit. So let's get started. Okay. Track number one, Going Way Back. That features KRS-One and shit like that. By the way, KRS-One, he's the only feature on his album, and he appears on this song and the next song too. Oh, I forgot the singles. Give me 1 second. I forgot about the singles. I believe the singles are Going Way Back, I want to say, and I think that's the only single, Going Way Back. I want to say that's the only single, because they had a video for that song too, so yeah. Okay, but anyway, track number one, Going Way Back, that features KRS-One. Yeah, that's a very dope song, nice song to begin the album with and shit like that. What I got from that song, it pretty much, not only does it set the tone for the album, but it kind of picked up where Boogie Down Productions' South Bronx left off, as Just Ice was pretty much, you know, shouting out, you know, the pioneers of the Bronx and shit like that, the people in Bronx that been doing their thing and shit. Yeah, very, very dope track, and shit, video's dope. I like when, in the beginning, when he's starting to rhyme and KRS-One interrupts him and he's like, what's the purpose of you stopping me and shit, you know, that kind of aggressive tone and shit. So, Going Way Back, very dope song. KRS-One, he did his thing on a song and a beat too. Track number two, The Original Gangsta of Hip Hop. Interesting story is that this song is actually a sequel to, if I'm not mistaken, The Gangsta of Hip Hop off the Back to the Old School. I think it's called Gangsta of Hip Hop, yeah. Back to the Old School and shit like that. But what's interesting about this version is that it gets more clarity on it and shit like that. Is a lot more better than the original and shit. And it still reunites him with, you know, DMX. No, not the Rough Riders DMX people think about. The original, the beatboxing DMX that people, you know, talk about and shit like that. So yeah, with that being said and shit like that, yeah, that's pretty much, oh, also with this song too, I think he threw a shot at Mr. Magic too with this track, because there's a line where he says, there's a line with this tragic magic and throw them away because we're not down together as one big fam. And I'm guessing the reason that he went after Mr. Magic was because, you know, KRS-One, you know, Boogie Down Productions and the Juice Crew was having their beef back at that time too. So, you know, just Ice kind of threw a shot at him and stuff like that. So, yeah, pretty much and shit. So, you know. Track number three, Freedom of Speech. Love that fucking track. The beat definitely sounds like it could have been like done for the By Any Means Necessary era and shit like that. Yeah, very dope track. I love some of the lines he was saying where he said some shit like, I'm a voyager for rhythm, a pirate for a rhyme. My voice is the vessel, now my mind must climb to a much higher plane that's my domain. Devastate and fascinate all but no strain, too reliable to reason, a victim of sense. Rise up to the season and don't be dense. Like, he just went in on this fucking song, and the beat was definitely dope too. Yeah. Track number four, Mosh It Up. This is another song that features KRS-One. My personal opinion, my personal favorite song off this album, and this is like a perfect example of hip hop reggae at the finest. As a matter of fact, this is probably one of the most perfect hip-hop reggae tracks and shit like that, you know what I'm saying? And the song was notable because it features the iconic hip-hop line, "Suicide is the suicide," which I saw a KRS-One interview when I was reviewing this album, and he said that that line kind of came from a famous like Patois lyric and shit like that, you know, and that fucking line was sampled from everybody, from the Grave Diggers to Snoop and shit like that, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, mashed up, basically. It's crazy too because with both Just Ice and KRS-One having like battle hip hop roots and shit like that, they didn't really battle on this song and shit like, you know, they were just pretty much having fun. And that's one thing I really pretty much liked about this track. They were just having fun on the mic and shit like that. You kinda see that KRS-One's like a little bit more laid back on this track and shit like that. Just Ice, you know, he's still himself, you know, but he's not like as aggressive as he is on like some of these other songs too. So fucking mashed up, that's definitely a favorite of mine and shit like that. I felt like, you know, Just Ice did his thing too and shit like that, you know what I'm saying? So I think he did his thing. He shined more on this track. Alright, that was mashed up. Track number 5, Kool and Deadly. Yeah, this is another song that reunites him with the human beatbox, DMX and shit like that. One thing I like about this track was the fact that this track pretty much has like a live hip hop feel and shit like that. It has like a live hip hop feel and shit where you hear like the crowd applauding and shit, you know what I'm saying, you know. And yeah, when it comes to beatboxing, you know, DMX don't get his shine when it comes to that beatboxing and shit, cause you know, people want to talk about Biz Markie and, you know, Dougie Fresh. And you know, no shots against those two because I love Biz Markie and Dougie Fresh, but yeah, DMX definitely did his thing when it came to like those early Just Ice records and shit, you know. You know, Just Ice saying shit like, "I'm deadly as a mantis, can hurt you like a tumor. Just Ice is my name and it's a New York rumor. Matronix programming while I examine beats move. Swift and highly advancing, deep rough sound in my gangster voice. Hard rock response, make it first choice." Like, yeah, very, very dope and shit like that, you know. His fucking punchlines at that time too, man, was just so ill, you know. Track number 6, On the Strength. Love this fucking track. Pretty much one of my favorite KRS-One beats on this album because it has a fucking drum, the drums and shit like that, but then in the fucking background, it sounds like there's like some glass or some shit in the background, which kind of adds like a more grimy aspect to the fucking beat, you know what I'm saying? So very cool. The fucking first verse, he's talking about he's shouting out hip-hop pioneers before. And it's kind of like being, you know, Just Ice's thing, you know, shout out hip-hop pioneers. And even his first album is called Back to the Old School for a reason, so. And the second verse is pretty much more of like a braggadocio verse and shit, so. That's one thing I got from On the Strength. Track number 7, Lyric Licking. Oh my fucking god, that's pretty much my second favorite song on this album. And it's like a reggae beat, that reggae beat too and shit like that. Ooh. Man, like, this track is so ill and shit, like, that fucking bass line, man, KRS-One does not get the props he deserves when it comes to the production, and I'm gonna talk more about that after and shit like that, but, yeah, fucking Lyric Licking, I love this fucking track. Yeah, he definitely did his thing, he went in on this shit. And track number 8, Booger Bandit Bitch. Man, that fucking name. Yeah, Just Ice, man, when it comes to Just Ice, a lot of the songs he aims towards females, man, it's just either love it or hate it and shit like that. With this song, it kind of takes two elements from LaToya and This Girl Is a Slut from Back to the Old School. Like, the first verse is like a lot more storytelling where it's in the same vein as, you know, LaToya and shit like that, you know what I'm saying? Just saying he got a story about to tell you about this girl and shit like that, you know. But then the second verse, he's getting into more about a bugger bandit bitch, and it takes on the same vein as this girl is a slut, where it's like a lot more profane, a lot more vulgar, which is something that Just Ice is very known for and shit like that. And it kind of continues on throughout the third verse as well and shit like that. So yeah, very, very dope track. Love that track. And track number 9 is the Freedom of Speech 88, the 12-inch single edit, you know. And that's all the songs off this album. This album right here is a very dope album. It's a classic. It's a classic album. You know, a lot of people won't call it a cult classic, you know. Just Ice. You know, when it comes to my favorite Just Ice album, I either have to go with either this one or the Desolate one, which I'm going to save my thoughts on that one when I review it. But yeah, with this album right here, you know, it's very... His chemistry with KRS-One was definitely going places that was at a prime at this one with the hip-hop reggae and shit like that. I felt like with this album, he kind of gets into like a lot more subject matter compared to Back to the Old School. Well, like with Back to the Old School, very, I love that album, but it's like, it was like a lot more like braggadocio. It did have its storytelling tracks too, but with this one, it just upped the ante and shit, you know what I'm saying? Now with the production, I want to talk about, you know, KRS-One definitely did his thing with the reggae production and shit like that. Stepped his game up from, well, actually, no, because I can't even say, because, you know, what did he produce any? He produced one song from Criminal Minded. Let me double check. Because you guys should know that that album was majorly produced by Seth G. Oh, well, he contributed basically to the production, so it was kind of like a partnership thing. What, 9mm Gold Bang, Elementary, which he did with Scott LaRock, okay. But yeah, so it could be said that this is pretty much the first album where he did the production on his own, and, well, him and Just Ice and shit. And I gotta say, he definitely did his thing and shit like that, you know. Definitely found his style. Even though the Metronic style, I love that album, but this is the album I like a lot of people most accustomed Just Ice to and shit like that. So yeah, very dope album. Love this album. And I believe this album is actually out of print. So if you can find this album, must have in your collection. This is Just Ice with Kool and Deadly, released in 1987. And yeah. Also, tonight, Fucking My Way review at 9 o'clock. Yeah, so it's gonna be epic. Y'all do not want to miss this. And so I'm about to actually possibly start filming the Desolate One in a minute. So this is your boy Reg here. Peace.